McCain just issues sick anti-American order to commissioned officers about what they must to do Trump now. America's most infamous traitor, John McCain, has been obsessed to take out Trump from the day our new president was sworn into office. We learned recently that McCain was behind the fake Russian dossier against Trump, and has been feeding leaks to the liberal media, where the icing on the cake came several weeks ago when McCain officially killed the Obamacare repeal, becoming the left's instant hero. But amazingly, the two-time failed presidential candidate still isn't done putting the screws to America. The brain-rotting crustacean gave the commencement speech for the U.S. Naval Academy this week, where he decided to throw not only our president under the bus, but our entire country as well. And the order McCain gave to these newly commissioned officers will leave you in complete disbelief. It doesn't come as much of a surprise that given the golden opportunity to publicly bash Trump, that McCain would jump at the chance. What is surprising, however, is that John McCain, who fancies himself as a war hero, would tell these newly commissioned officers to not put America first. McCain began his speech by predictably taking a swipe at Trump and his entire administration. But later in the speech is when McCain proved to the world just how many brain cells he's apparently lost with his recent brain cancer diagnosis, where he made the asinine demand that these newly commissioned officers should not put America first, and should try to blend with other countries such as Europe. McCain said that as a statesman, that he had concluded that the American example and American leadership are indispensable to securing a peaceful and prosperous future, and that there could be no more isolationism, no more tired resignation, no more America first. Putting America first is the very reason that young men and women decide to sign up for the military in the first place, but apparently the message of patriotism and love for country are attributives that John McCain has lost along the way, as he's stepped on literally everyone in his path over the years to ensure that his own selfish personal political agendas were fulfilled. Perhaps McCain's callous attitude towards our country and his sentiments of no more America first came to fruition back on July 31, 1967 when he killed 134 of his fellow sailors while aboard the USS Forrestal aircraft carrier. According to eyewitnesses that day, whose accounts were predictably buried by the Navy due to John McCain's familial ties to two four-star admirals, McCain decided to be a show-off, by doing a wet start of his jet. This reckless maneuver makes fuel build up in the engine before the plane is started. The result is a flame erupting from the tail of the plane, that's accompanied by a startling amount of noise. After McCain started his engine in this manner, the electrical surge of this maneuver subsequently caused the accidental launching of a powerful Zuni rocket across the carrier's deck, that hit two other parked planes that were packing 1,000-pound highly explosive bombs. Or perhaps McCain's sentiments of not putting America first was bred from his selfish desires after being rescued as a POW, where he would then go on to bury evidence of there being other POWs held by the Vietnamese for his own selfish political reasons. 3 months after the bloody tragedy on the USS Forrestal aircraft carrier, John McCain was sent on a bombing mission over Hanoi in October of 1967 when he was shot down and captured by the North Vietnamese, where he's go on to be a prisoner of war until 1973. After being released from captivity, McCain would use his POW story and veteran status to rise to political prominence, where his image as a Vietnam War hero would go on to propel him to be elected as a United States Senator. But a hero is the last thing that John McCain was or will ever be. What most people don't know is the massive government scandal that McCain helped hide, as he'd go on for decades to tirelessly work to bury stunning information about American prisoners over in Vietnam who, unlike him, didn't return home. Using his position as a senator, McCain would be behind the scenes quietly pushing and sponsoring federal laws that would keep the most damning information about our POWs buried through classified documents. More evidence of traitor McCain not putting America first was on full display several months ago, after the disturbing bombshell was leaked about how he's basically owned by George Soros and Muslim terrorists. After a little digging was done into the McCain Institute, a rather suspicious donor list immediately began sending off alarm bells. One of his most generous donors to McCain's organization is the Royal Embassy of Saudi Arabia, the very same Muslims linked to the 9/11 terror attack. Yep, that's right. John McCain is owned by Muslims. Share this story and help expose what a massive traitor John McCain truly is. Not only has his life been full of treason and his own selfish ambitions, but he's now attempting to pass the torch of treason to these newly commissioned officers, in an effort to ensure there's other people inside our government hating America just as much as he does.